everyone, and welcome to day 11. I sure hope you're doing well, and I hope you're getting much out of the silence in meditation. 2 Peter chapter 1, verses 2 through 4 read like this: May grace and peace be multiplied to you in the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. His divine power has granted to us all things that pertain to life and godliness, through the knowledge of him who called us to his own glory and excellence, by which he has granted to us his precious and very great promises, so that through them you may become partakers of the divine nature, having escaped from the corruption that is in the world because of sinful desire. Today we're going to talk about abundance and what's called the law of least effort. A part of the flow of abundance is a principle that is called least effort. It's a part of how abundance comes to us. When we are aligned, soul, spirit, source, we are aligned with the mind of God, and abundance flows effortlessly. We do not have to work for abundance. It flows to us. We can do less and accomplish more, but first we have to practice acceptance. The more you accept the circumstances of your life in this moment, the easier your life becomes. When you struggle against this moment, you actually struggle against the will of God. Because in this moment, there are lessons, opportunities, and answers. The principle or the law of least effort is trusting that everything in the moment is as it should be. Seeing your life as it is right now, particularly if you want to change something, is a requirement for the change to occur. Accept this moment, then that allows abundance to come to you without effort. Practice today the law of least effort by doing the following. Number one, examine your life. Accept all things and all people in your life right at this moment, exactly as they are. Number two, take responsibility for your life without blaming yourself, knowing things are exactly as God would have them to be. Number three, practice defenselessness and let go the need to convince or persuade others of your point of view. The principle shows us that we do not control the outcome and we do not control the flow of the input. This principle supports us with the idea of patience, waiting, and most importantly, trusting. Faith is the element that drives the flow of abundance. It teaches us to let go of the outcomes in the development of our intentions, which are our clear visions. When your actions are motivated by love, you develop energy that is multiplied and accumulated, and the release of this energy allows you to redirect it and use it to create everything that you want to create. When your spirit is your inner point of reference, all the power of love is at your disposal. And you can use this energy creatively, moving toward abundance and not negative things. So as we look at our task for today, it's kind of strange, but stay with me. This will take a couple of days. In your notebook, think about your mother. And when I say this is going to take a couple of days, what I mean is there'll be 2 days that are focused on your mother. Not that it will take you so long to do this, that it will take a period of 2 days. But in your notebook, describe your mother. Describe her positive aspects. Describe her limitations. Notice I did not say describe her negative aspects. I said limitations. Then consider, what did you learn from her? What brought you together? What kinds of things separated you or distanced you? If your mother is no longer in this world, then focus on her image. Join her in the image and write whatever arises in your memory and your feelings, your emotions. For some of you, this will not be easy. If this is the case, while doing it, try to distance yourself from the personal experience you had with your mom. See her as just a human, a woman living her own life. When I had to do this exercise, I envisioned my mother as being a woman that visited our Sunday school class. I didn't know anything about her. I only know my personal interactions with her, what I remembered. And so do the same. See your mother as a woman, not just your parent. So as we prepare for our meditation, our centering phrase is this: I expect and accept abundance to flow easily to me. I expect and accept abundance to flow easily to me. And so the mantra today is accept, release. Accept, release. So as we move into our time of meditation, you're sitting in a comfortable position. Your hands are lightly in your lap, palms facing upward. You begin to close your eyes and you begin to realize and notice your breath. You're breathing in and you're breathing out. And with each breath, you get more and more comfortable. Breathe in, accept. Breathe out, release. Remember to use the mantra when any kind of distraction comes, when any kind of bodily distraction tries to hinder you. Breathe in, accept. Breathe out, release. Breathe in, accept. Breathe out, release. At the sound of the chime, you may begin. Breathe in, accept. Breathe out, release. And we begin now. Amen. Beloved, it's time to release the mantra. Say it one more time in your spirit. Accept. Release. I know that the assignment may be a little difficult, but you can do it. Your answers are waiting. You don't have to judge yourself. You just have to realize your life as it is right now. It's on the verge of change. You cannot change what you do not acknowledge. And so I'm praying for you, and I know you'll do well. So until tomorrow, say love.